Hello friends, myself Dr. Deepak, and today we are going to learn about the anatomy of ear. So let me start. So the ear, for the descriptive purpose, ear is divided in the three parts: the external ear, the middle ear, and the internal ear. This whole structure, it lies within the cavity of the temporal bone on the lateral aspect of the skull. The main function of the ear is of hearing, but it is also converges the sound waves, then conduct, then modified, enhance, and analyze the sound waves. So these all functions are done with the ear. So we will start from the external ear. This structure, the layman's know this outer part of the ear as an ear, but this is known as the auricle or the pinna in the anatomical language. So this external part of the ear, it is known as a auricle or the pinna. Then the auricle is continue in one tube, and this tube, it is known as a external acoustic meatus or external auditory tube. On the medial end of this external auditory tube, there is a one membrane, and this membrane, it is known as a tympanic membrane. Okay, on the medial aspect of this tympanic membrane, there is one cube shaped cavity, and this cube shaped cavity, it is known as a middle ear cavity. What? Middle ear cavity. So actually the tympanic membrane, it separate the external ear from the middle ear. Okay, so it is lies on the transition between the external ear and the middle ear. So sometimes in some books we learn it with the external ear, and sometimes we learn it with the middle ear. Okay, so it is actually in the transition zone of the external ear and the middle ear cavity. Okay, so we first discuss about the external ear. So the external ear is formed by the two main structures, and they are the pinna or the auricle and the external acoustic meatus or the auditory tube. Okay, here we will discuss the tympanic membrane in the external with the external ear. So this is known as the auricle or the pinna. Okay, then this is the external acoustic meatus, and finally the tympanic membrane. Okay, so the auricle or the pinna, it is formed by an elastic cartilage, and it is covered on both the side by the skin. Okay, you can see that on both the side it is covered by a skin. Its lowest part, it is not formed by the cartilage, it is a fibrofatty part, and its lowest part, it is known as a lobule. So this structure, it is known as a lobule and it is formed by the fibrofatty tissue. Okay, then there is a one large depressed area in this auricle, and this depressed area, it is known as a concha. What? The concha. So here you can see that this large depressed area, it is continuous with the external acoustic meatus. So this area, it is known as a concha. Okay, then some other parts of the auricle or the pinna, they are the, this is a helix, then the antihelix, then this area, it is known as a scaphoid fossa, and this, it is known as a simba concha. What? Simba concha. Okay, here is a tragus and antitragus. So this, okay, this triangular elevation, it is known as a tragus, and opposite to that, this is a antitragus. So this is a tragus and antitragus. Okay, so this is about the auricle or the pinna. So the auricle or the pinna, it is the outermost part of the ear. The lamens known this area as the ear. Okay, and it is formed by the elastic cartilage, and it is covered on both the side by the skin. Its lowest part, it is formed by the fibrofatty tissue, and it is known as a lobule. Then some other parts are the helix, the antihelix, scaphoid fossa, simba concha, tragus, antitragus. The concha, it is a large depression in this auricle, and it is continuous with the external acoustic meatus. Okay, now the most important, the artery supply and the nerve supply of the ear. So here this is the ear. Okay, so it has a two surfaces, the outer surface, this, and this, it is a medial surface. So this is a lateral or the outer surface, and on the posterior side, this, it is a medial surface. So its outer surface, on its outer surface, it is upper two-third part and lower one-third part. So its upper two-third part, it is supplied by the auriculo temporal nerve, whereas its lower part, it is supplied by the great auricular nerve. Okay, now its medial part, so its medial part is upper two-third and lower one-third. So its upper two-third part, or its upper part, it is supplied by the laser occipital nerve, and its lower one-third part, it is supplied by the great auricular nerve. So on both the surfaces, its outer and the inner, or the lateral and the medial surface, its lower part, it is supplied by the great auricular nerve, but on the outer surface, its upper part is supplied by the auriculotemporal nerve, and on the medial surface, it is supplied by the laser occipital nerve. Okay, now the arteries. So two arteries are supplying the external ear, and these are the superficial temporal artery and posterior auricular artery. Okay, superficial temporal artery and the posterior auricular artery. Okay, So these two arteries are supplying to the ear. And finally, the lymphatics. So the preauricular and post-auricular lymph nodes. Okay, pre-auriculars on the anterior side, pre-auricular, and on the posterior side, post-auricular lymph nodes are present. So these pre-auricular and the post-auricular lymph nodes are draining the external the auricle or the pinna. Okay, so which nerves are supplying? So on the outer surface is upper part, it is supplied by the auriculotemporal, and lower part by the greater auricular nerve. On the posterior side is upper part by the lesser occipital nerve, and lower part it is greater auricular nerve. And the root, actually the root is the root of the ear, it is innervated by the auricular branch of vagus nerve. Which nerve? Auricular branch. Root means this area. Okay, so this a root of the auricle, it is innervated by the auricular branch of the vagus nerve. Okay, so this is about its nervous innervation. Then the arteries, two arteries, the superficial temporal artery and the posterior auricular artery, and the lymphatics are drained by the pre-auricular and the post-auricular lymph nodes. Okay, thank you very much.